Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 23rd of September. India's PM Modi attends Quad Summit, meets Indian diaspora and CEOs of tech giants. Sri Lankans pin hope on new president Dasa Naike to revive economy amid debt crisis. And Nepal court issues arrest warrant against former Home Minister Lami Chane over fraud allegations. And now for all the details. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi, along with leaders of Australia, Japan and the USA, this past weekend held a Quad Summit in Delaware in the United States. The farewell summit of the US President Joe Biden stressed the importance of maintaining the Quad, which Biden termed a signature foreign policy achievement. It saw leaders announcing joint Coast Guard operations next year that will include Australian, Japanese and Indian personnel spending time on a US Coast Guard vessel. The countries also plan increased military logistics cooperation along with planning to expand an Indo-Pacific partnership for maritime domain awareness launched 2 years ago. The Indian Prime Minister also held bilateral engagements with Australian PM Anthony Albanese, Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida and US President Joe Biden.
हम किसी के खिलाफ नहीं हैं। हम सभी एक रूल्स बेस्ड इंटरनेशनल ऑर्डर, संप्रभुता और क्षेत्रीय अखंडता के सम्मान और सभी मसलों के शांतिपूर्ण ढंग से हल निकालने का समर्थन करते हैं। फ्री, ओपन, इंक्लूसिव और प्रॉस्परस इंडो पैसिफिक हमारी साझा प्राथमिकता और साझा प्रतिबद्धता है।
Wrapping up his engagements in Delaware, the Indian Prime Minister arrived in New York as part of second stop of 3 days visit. Interacting with Indian diaspora at a packed coliseum in New York's Long Island suburbs that also featured Indian dancing and songs, PM Modi lauded the diaspora and said the American Indian community will take India-America relations to new heights. Later in the day, the Indian Prime Minister also held a roundtable with CEOs of leading tech giants, including Adobe CEO Shantanu Narayan, Alphabet CEO Sundar Pichai, both of who are of Indian origin.
We are robustly investing in AI in India, and we look forward to doing more. We have several programs in partnership with METI, the Agriculture and Health Ministries, the central and state governments, and we look forward to doing more in India.
PM Modi is also scheduled to address the Summit of the Future at the UN General Assembly on Monday. Ahead of the address, he held bilateral meetings with Crown Prince of Kuwait, Sheikh Sabah Khalid Al Hamad Al Sabah and Palestine President Mohammed Abbas and discussed issues of mutual interest. He also met Nepal's Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli, the first since the communist leader assumed charge of the Himalayan nation. Meanwhile, Pakistan's Prime Minister Shehbaz Sharif will participate in the 79th session of the United Nations General Assembly, where he will address the UNGA on 27 September, Pakistan's Foreign Ministry announced on Sunday. In a statement, the Foreign Ministry said Sharif in his address will raise the issue of Palestine, along with the issue of Jammu and Kashmir at the Global Forum. This is not the first time Pakistani Premier will rake up Kashmir at the United Nations. Former Premiers including Nawaz Sharif, Imran Khan along with Shehbaz Sharif have repeatedly raked up Kashmir during their UNGA address. India has condemned the statements from Pakistani Prime Ministers and maintains in order to establish peace in South Asia, Islamabad needs to stop cross-border terrorism and shut down its infrastructure of terrorism immediately. New Delhi has said the entire Jammu and Kashmir region is an integral and inalienable part of India and Islamabad has no locus standi on it. A roadside bomb hit a convoy of foreign diplomats visiting Pakistan's Swat on Sunday, killing a police officer in their security detail. Soldiers and police searched the area after the bombing and imposed a curfew. Swat District Police Officer said that the diplomats were visiting the Swat Valley area on the invitation of the local Chamber of Commerce to showcase it as a potential tourist destination. Four other police officers were also wounded, but the nearly dozen diplomats were safe, the official said. No one has so far claimed responsibility for the attack, which was condemned by Pakistan President Asif Ali Zardari. The nationalities of the diplomats were not immediately clear. Pakistani counter-terrorist forces maintain a strong presence in the Swat Valley, which has long been a hotbed of Islamist militant insurgency. The militants have stepped up their attacks since late 2022 after breaking a ceasefire with the government. Moving on, ad hoc government employees of POJK staged a protest recently to demand the implementation of a 2021 legislation that promised permanent positions. The protesters accused while their counterparts in Pakistan have been regularized, they continue to face job insecurity and low wages. A report.
Ad hoc employees in various government departments in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir held a protest recently in front of the Central Press Club in Muzaffarabad to demand regularization. They demanded the enforcement of a 2021 legislation for regularization that has not been implemented yet. The protesters said, while employees in other parts of Pakistan have been granted permanent positions, those in POJK are often laid off.
अदालत ने भी आपके लिए अच्छाई दे दी कि जी आप कर लें। हुकूमतें किस लिए होती हैं? हुकूमत की मदद लोगों के आवाम के लिए, आवाम के खिलाफ। दोबारा मेरा सवाल है, एक डाक को निकाल कर दूसरे को लगा देना, ये कोई अकलमंदी है? अब बाकी रहा कि जो 5 साल बचे हुए लोग, जो 5 साल जिनकी नौकरी कम है, लगाए इश्तिहार, इश्तिहार में वो लोग भी जाए।
The problem of ad hoc employment in POJK is a long-standing and contentious issue in the occupied region. The contractual employees face job insecurity and often receive lower wages than permanent staff, despite performing similar duties.
Anura Kumaradisa Naike, a Marxist-leaning politician, took oath as Sri Lanka's president on Monday, a day after he won comprehensive victory in the debt-ridden South Asian country's presidential election. About 75% of the 17 million eligible voters cast their ballots in the poll on Saturday, according to the Election Commission. This was the country's first election since its economy buckled in 2022 under a severe foreign exchange shortage, leaving it unable to pay for imports of essentials including fuel, medicine and cooking gas. Protest forced then-President Gotabaya Rajapaksa to flee and later resign. Residents have now pinned hope on Disa Naike, who comes from a small farmer household, to revive the economy.
මේ ආර්ථිකය දුප්පත් මිනිස්සුගේ ආර්ථික නගා සිටවන්න ඕනේ. ඒක තමයි ප්‍රධානම බලාපොරොත්තු.
බලාපොරොත්තු දෙ සිද්ධ වුණා. අවශ්‍යලා තියෙන්නේ මේ කඩාවැටිච්ච රට ගොඩනගන්න. ඒ කියන්නේ මේ ආර්ථික වශයෙන් ගොඩනගන්න ආර්ථිකය. විශේෂයෙන්ම ආර්ථිකයේ සදාචාරය සමෘද්ධිය يعني ජනතාවගේ දුක ඇති කරන පාලනයක් තමයි අපි අවශ්‍යලා තිබ්බේ.
Knocking out incumbent President Ranil Wickremesinghe and opposition leader Sajith Premadasa, Disa Naike put faith in his pledge to fight corruption and bolster a fragile economic recovery following the South Asian nation's worst financial crisis in decades. In the election, he polled 1.27 million votes more than nearest rival and main opposition leader Sajith Premadasa, while the incumbent president Ranil Wickremesinghe finished third. Although Dissanayake's JVP has just 3 seats in the parliament, the 55-year-old candidate was boosted by his promises of tough anti-corruption measures and bigger welfare schemes. He has promised to dissolve parliament within about 45 days of coming to power and to seek a fresh mandate in the general elections for his policies.
පොදු පුරවැසියන්ට සියලු ශේෂ්ත්‍රවලට විශාල වගකීමක් තිබෙනවා මා හැම දිනාගම සහය අපේක්ෂා කරන ඒ වගකීම ඉටු කිරීම වෙනුවෙන් නමුත් අප තේරුම් ගන්න තිබෙනවා රටේ ජනාධිපතිවරයා ලෙස මේ කාර්ය මෙහෙවීමේදී ප්‍රමුඛතම හා
The Kaski District Court has issued an arrest warrant against Nepal's former Home Minister and the chairman of Rashtriya Swatantra Party, Rabi Lamichhane, over his alleged involvement in misappropriations of funds from various cooperatives while managing the Gorkha Media Network. Soon after the court order, party workers gathered at RSP office chanting slogans against the government and the court order based on the recommendations of a parliamentary probe committee. They claimed Lamichhane has been framed by the state given his popularity within a short span of time. Earlier in the afternoon, former Deputy Inspector General Chabilal Joshi, partner of Lamichhane at Gorkha Media Network, was also arrested. Lamichhane hosts a popular television show founded the RSP in June 2022. It is the fourth largest party in parliament with 21 lawmakers including the deputy speaker. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.